Hi, my name is Patrick Faulkner. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today, I'll be showing you a Fender Twin from the mid-70s. This is the master volume one with the push-pull circuit. So if you have one of those, this will definitely pertain to you. If you don't and you're thinking of getting a Fender, I actually think this is a great option if you're interested in learning how to modify amps. There's a bunch of stuff in it that's good. There's a bunch of stuff in it that's not good. And you have the opportunity to kind of deal with that as you see fit. So, if that seems interesting to you, I'll show you what I've learned and we can dig into this amp and see what works and what doesn't work. So, stick around and I hope you enjoy the video.
Okay, so here's the amp. It's not really put together, but loosely, this is kind of what it looks like. Here's the front panel. It's pretty clean overall. In the camera, I can see there's some dark lines right around here, maybe down here, because it's old. It's basically all original. I'll show you the back. I have the original plug, but while I was testing, I just put an extra long one in so I didn't bend the speaker wires. And then I replaced the speakers. This is an old EV, Electro Voice. I think it's like a 200 watt speaker. And then this is, I'd have to check again. I don't remember what that one is off the top of my head. But anyways, pretty clean. I put four tubes back in. Originally I was gonna have it run two, but I think the sample one are a little bit better with the four, at least in the current way that the bias circuit is. Still have the original reverb cables. Everything else is pretty much the same. Notice I pulled the ABA ground switch off, and I have the original plug still on it. I had to do a little repair on it because, you know, it's old. So. And somebody had like hacked the cable. They had like taped it back together. So I had to redo all of that. But pretty nice overall. The original reverb can still in there. So just kind of giving you the overview of what this Silverface looks like. Pretty clean for what it is. I don't know exactly what they paid for it, but I would think somewhere in the neighborhood of $600 or $800. So, let's try. Let's see if this works. So you can see down here, tubes are glowing. So there's definitely power to the amp, right? So this is how I dump voltage out of an amp. It's pretty easy. I learned it from a guy who helped me do a mod kit for a VHT Special 6. So you can see here, the amp is definitely plugged into a speaker output, right? Need that. Because we need to dump the voltage out of the amp. Okay, so we definitely know there's electricity. You touch that, it's gonna hurt. Okay? So, cool. So, now what we need to do is we need to dump the electricity, the voltage that's in the amp, out through the speaker cable. So there's two things I'm gonna do. Let's pretend the amp was on. So now I want to power it down, right? Push the standby switch. That'll cut the voltage to the tubes. Okay, cool. Then I turn it off. So now all the voltage is gone, right? No. Actually, the first thing you got to do is you flip the standby switch up. Still plugged in. Then I go to the wall. I unplug the power from the wall. Then, last tip, turn on the amp. Connect the flow so the current can flow through the amp, through all the components, and then flow out to here. So you're dumping all the capacitors in the amp. Okay, so let's start kind of near the beginning of what I was working on. So the first thing I did was I replaced these 470 ohm resistors. These needed to be replaced. I've been watching some other YouTubers and they talk about different things that you should do to these amps. So I replaced these ones and then the 1.5K resistors down here. So I wanted to make sure that the tubes were running at the best possible voltages. And because this amp is so old and I know the noise problems with it, I figured I might as well just replace these parts since they're going to be a culprit in noise. I ended up using Carbon Comps for the 1.5K. I probably shouldn't have done that. I think if I could go back, I would have used the metal films, which if you look down here, I didn't do these all in sync. That's what I did here. So that will likely get replaced in the future just because I know that the Carbon Comps have a little bit more noise going on. The metal oxide resistors I think are great. They handle a lot of power. They more than likely I think wouldn't need to be replaced for another 20, 25 years. So the next thing I replaced were the output coupling caps here. I also replaced the resistors that control the phase inverter plate resistors. I replaced these as well, and you can see I replaced them with some Carbon Comps. I think I'm going to get rid of these. I know they're new. Resistors aren't terribly expensive. I think if you want to try them out, I think they're worth, you know, they end up being like 15 or 20 cents a piece. If you try them out, you don't like them, I think you can replace them. That's fine. I am actually not fully done with this bias circuit yet. This is still using the stock 70s bias circuit. I'm not sure yet. I need to talk to my friend about it and see what he wants to do. I would prefer to put the 60s blackface adjustable bias circuit in. I haven't done that because it's not my amp. And I want to keep it as close to stock as I can until at first I'm still just trying to figure out noise problems. So everybody seems to agree. I've watched three or four different YouTubers about this. Everybody seems to agree about this. Replace them. These will leak high voltage and they can destroy your output tubes. So clearly if I'm seeing or hearing a lot of noise that's coming from the output section, those are the things I wanted to replace. So that was the next section of things that I did. After that, you can see down here, the phase inverter circuit, I basically replaced the whole thing. The capacitor, all the resistors. The only thing I couldn't replace was the negative feedback coupling capacitor. I didn't have the right value for it. And when I tried to put two caps in parallel, it didn't work. So maybe I did my math wrong, I don't know. So I just put the stock one back in. Everything seems to be working fine for right now, so I'm gonna just leave it at this moment. At some point if I want to, I can replace it, but I'm trying not to replace everything. But fixing the phase inverter circuit actually greatly reduced the noise on the amp. I was watching all these videos of guys fixing guitar amps and then don't know how to play guitar. It was making me laugh. So that's what kind of inspired me to do it, because I'm a guitar teacher by trade. So that's what kind of inspired me.
sounds like with...
Okay, so this is where I found most of my noise problems. It was all in the reverb circuit. And I still may find more, but I know that this amp was running way too hot for way too long. And I feel like because the high voltage was running through the amp, I don't really know how all that works, but I know that when you have certain components out of spec, it's going to push on other components. And so even after I had replaced the previous components and all the filter caps, I was still having a lot of noise issues, like unbearably loud noise issues. I'm not going to use a screwdriver to point into the amp, so I'll just use my finger. I've already dumped all the voltage out of this amp. If you'd like, I can show you how to do that as well. I'm not afraid to touch it because I've already done that. So don't worry. If you don't know how to dump voltage out of your amp, please don't touch the amp. Okay. I had to replace a bunch of components to start getting it out. Mostly here, this capacitor, the reverb output coupling capacitor, and what was this one? Vibrato channel. No, not the treble. Although I did replace the treble capacitor here. That actually helped a lot. I took out the ceramic disc caps. This one is actually a replaced ceramic disc cap. You can see it. That one was replaced because it was a part I had on hand. I guess when I purchased these, I hadn't purchased all the correct values that I needed. So I wasn't able to replace that with a silver mica. But I was able to replace the treble ones in the channels here and here. That helped a ton because they're better at filtering high voltage and high frequencies than the disc caps are. The disc caps were super microphonic. And, you know, if you've ever tapped on a tube, dunk, 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 and you hear that sound, the capacitors themselves here and here, and actually this one down here, you might not think of this one. I've replaced this. They were all wildly microphonic. And actually the whole channel remained microphonic until I replaced these two caps here. These ones were actually sending their microphonic thing through the rest of the channel. So even after I had replaced these ones and this resistor, there was still a ton of noise. So after replacing this cap down here, let me get that in focus. Then I was really able to isolate the noise out and get a ton of it out. At this point, the only real noise is actually down here in the volume pot. So I'm considering replacing that volume pot. It's just more money at this point. And I'll talk to my friend and see if he wants to do it. It's very slight. In the future, will the pot fail? Maybe. It was probably getting voltage that it really didn't need to be seeing because the amp was running really hot. I mean, it turns fine. It adjusts the volume's fine, but when I tap on it, there's still some sensitivity, but it's very minimal. And I'm not sure if replacing it at this point it will actually get rid of it, just because when you use that channel, obviously you're going to hear some sound. So I'm debating whether or not to replace it since it still functions. And getting rid of a lot of these other capacitors was more of the issue.
Neighbors. So down here is the preamp section of the amp. And you'll notice these are still the stock blue caps that come in the amp. I didn't replace them. That was kind of a personal choice. I have played this amp for a couple years, so I know exactly what it sounds like. I actually really like the way the amp sounds. And I realized that just replacing capacitors, people say there's certain mojo. I don't always believe that. You know, I don't always believe, well, you got to replace all these things to make it sound better. They're the same values, maybe mildly better, but these are all mid and low frequency caps here. They're not necessarily going to be a noticeable difference. The ones that I did replace, though, were here. These are silver mica caps. When I was putting this together and I made my shopping list, I missed a silver mica cap. So I had an extra 280 instead of the 250 picofarads caps. It makes this channel a little bit darker. And I actually like it a lot. When I flip the bright switch, it's actually usable. There's not so many bright frequencies that it's an unuseful tool. So it actually made the channel more usable. For somebody who maybe doesn't want to use the reverb in the amp and just wanted a clean channel, I think it actually worked really well. I think it'll be a really nice sounding channel. You'll notice I didn't replace the carbon comp resistors here, mostly because I don't use this channel. This channel doesn't seem to be getting as much use, and it doesn't have as much noise. If you look at the preamp down here for the reverb channel, you'll notice I did replace all those resistors. Because this amp had so much noise in it, replacing these resistors was maybe a mild upgrade. I don't think it was really the issue. It's just one less thing I had on my list to deal with. And as I'm working through this, I need to kind of take things off the list. Definitely replace the electrolytics. I'm having to look this up. Cathode resistor capacitor. So it's running off of the cathode of the preamp tubes. Definitely replace these because those old Mallorys are dead. They're done. They've served their purpose. They will leak. And the last thing I want to do is get these old Mallorys, let them die in the amp. So because I was dealing with voltage problems, those are the first things I'm going to do. Okay, so here's kind of the last section that I'm really dealing with in this amp. And I feel like this is where the amp really is stuck. Now that I've replaced a bunch of the caps and the resistors in the front end of the amp, I'm kind of dealing with the bias circuit. And I feel like this is where the amp is really kind of stuck. This is a 70s twin, and you'll notice the 70s twin has a diode rectifier, super cheap. Also, I feel like it sounds great. Personally, I actually like the stiffness of the diode rectifier. The problem is this amp doesn't have an adjustable bias. This pot is not really a bias adjuster. Let's get it back in focus. It's not a bias adjusting pot. It's, what did they call it? A hum balance. It's a hum balance pot. So I can adjust minutely. It's probably 5 or 10K of some actual real adjustment. I think it's a 25K pot. I'd have to check the schematic again, but whatever it is, it's not doing a lot of bias really. It's just trying to adjust quote unquote the hum. So what it does is it allows you to use tubes quote unquote that aren't matched. And I feel like that is not what you would want to do with your amp. You're kind of shortchanging the quality of the tone, making it quote-unquote bulletproof. I feel like it actually will make the amp run cold. And yeah, I can put whatever tubes I want in it now, And in fact, this particular amp doesn't even have a matched set of tubes. It has two tubes that are JJ's and two tubes that are Ruby tubes. So my friend, his amp is actually the quintessential proof of this concept. Is yes, you can run tubes that aren't matched and it'll work fine. Like, the amp sounds pretty good on its own. I think if I wanted to get all of the hum that's in the transformer out down here, I'd have to change the bias circuit. That's the only thing that's left. There's really not much left in the amp. There's a couple of resistors up here that are original carbon comps. I've replaced these resistors. There may be a slight amount of noise. I've checked these resistors. They all seem fine. I replaced this one negative bias resistor just to make 100% sure that I'm getting the best voltage to the tubes through that. This cap actually had been replaced because I assumed that the original Mallory that I have up here failed. There was a big burn mark inside the amp in that spot. So I can see the remnants of this. I know this amp had been gone through by somebody else because they chopped out the master volume circuit, but they actually never fully took the whole thing out. So that was a fun fiasco having to deal with that. So the only thing left for me to do is to actually replace these resistors here, create a proper bias, adjustable bias circuit, following the 60s Fender, like blackface style, because this amp doesn't have the master volume anymore. But that would also require me to use, I would want to use a matched set of tubes at that point. If I'm going to have a set of tubes that are going to be running at a proper bias, I need tubes that are going to be matched more similarly. I know that the Rubies run hotter than the JJs. I can see it. I can feel it. Actually, on the tubes themselves, the vibrations that they give off. And you can see that when I flip up the standby switch, there's actually a noticeable amount of light. So I assume, I could be wrong, but I assume then that those tubes are just running that much hotter. And just to be sure, we can check our negative bias voltage here. The test points are actually at the ends of these caps. I don't have the resistors in the same way as the 60s one, so slightly different. But you can see it here, if it comes into autofocus. I got 51 on that left side, and then I'll test the one on the right. And you can see it there. Come on, it's coming. There we go. 47. So pretty close. 51, 47, pretty close. And you can leave the amp on standby. It's not any different. Current draw, I think, is different. If you're going to be measuring current, I think you have to do that with the standby up and the high voltage applied to the tubes. But for adjusting negative bias, we don't have to. I mean, not adjusting, for measuring it. It feels a little bit cold. I've seen other black faces running those at negative 45, negative 46, maybe negative 48. So the right side seems okay, but the left side seems cold, 51. So that doesn't make me happy. I would rather be able to adjust it maybe down to 40, 44, 45, and I can't. That's the problem with this particular bias circuit. And I've even tried using pulling two of the tubes. Let's dump our voltage. I've even tried pulling two of the tubes and halving the ohms, the output ohms, doesn't work. You would need to, and I figured this out, I would need to replace this cap here. Let me show you. Well, I would need to replace this cap here. It's the wrong value for an amp with two output tubes. It's too high. Right now it should be anywhere between 80 to 100 microfarads. It should be closer to 50 or even 20. I have the cap. I'm just, at this point, I want to keep the amp as it is and show it to my friend and then let him decide what he thinks we should do with it, because it's ultimately not mine. What I would do, absolutely, I'd even go and put in like 6V6s. I'd take the amp all the way down. I don't see the point nor the need for a 100-watt amp, especially since he's just going to use it for recording. But I think to do that, I'd end up having to replace the transformer. I could be wrong about that. I don't know at this point. These are just things I'm thinking about. Oh yeah, one other issue. When I was doing my tap tests, this cap kept coming up as microphonic. So I had another disc cap and I was able to replace that, and it seems to be working fine. So I'm going to just leave that one in there for this time being. This part of the amp is still kind of remains to be seen. This bias circuit is my thought process to get this amp to be in 100% pristine quality. I feel like that's the issue now.
So here's the amp. I'm about 2. Trebles at 3.5. Middle's at 5. Bass is just under 5. I'm just sitting in my garage. The reverb is at 3. So, with the reverb on about 2 or 3, I'll turn the delay off. I just turn it up a little bit. That vibration is actually my lens cap. That off the amp. Or maybe it's the amp in the cabinet. Because like I said, I didn't secure it. I just figured it was a little easier to show. Here's a little bit. A little bit of overdrive. I usually just leave my overdrive on all the time. I just kind of adjust the volume to fit. Whatever I'm doing. So I'll try to match the highs and match the lows. Wetness. Mm-hmm. a little extra. Yeah, that rattles something, because I know I just put the chassis back in, so it's because I didn't screw it back in. Overall, I'm pretty happy with it. I'd have to look. Here's with the noise gate. Totally off. I usually play with the gate on. I think it's worth it just to kind of knock out most of that. But then when I play, you can't hear it. If I sustain it without playing anything. And then adding in like an extra delay will help kind of fill in that space. Pretty happy with it so far.